We were live on Monday with our Works for Kids. Fantastic crowd, and now we're here. I'd love to tell you all they play wonderful. I can tell you they play wonderful, but we'll hear them in school when May 18th, I think, in the in-school concert. So with all of the kids you haven't heard, we had state testing this week, and you heard about it, thank you for doing it. We had too many changes to schedule, so we'll go live with our own friends next week. So are you ready to do this? You got this, right? All right. Mr. Krauss, you are one rock star music teacher. We are so happy to have you. So enjoy tonight. I'm Mr. Krauss. I want to play percussion. So if you ever need a substitute, I am your girl.
I know. I'll find
an appropriate part.
Right.
For the school concert.
I'm ready.
I got two sets of percussion.
I'm ready.
Yeah, I know you are. All right. Being in the band is the best thing, too. Well, welcome to our Eagles Spring Band concert. We've been waiting for this for quite some time. You can see in the program, we've got a lot of things that are going to be happening. We're going to be playing as a 4th and 5th grade combined group, as well as some things just for the 4th grade. Hopefully, you figured out that this is the 4th grade side, that was the 5th grade side. If you can see, you can probably still see things across the way, so it shouldn't be... shouldn't be too much of a hassle to do that. Okay? There's going to be some logistical things that we're going to be going over between songs that I'll be talking to the kids about. So don't fret. We haven't been together the whole week because we've had ESSA weeks and all kinds of other things. So there's going to be some adjusting tonight. We didn't get a full dress rehearsal because we are doing our in-school concert out of order. So this is sort of, you know, our dress rehearsal and performance for you at the same time. I'm sure it's going to go really, really well. And it's going to be a great celebration. It's a celebration of being done with BSSAs. It's a celebration of being, you can clap for that if you guys want to, because you want some more tests. It's a celebration of actually being back in the building and doing a live concert, which is huge. We don't have to stream this. We don't have to do anything. You know, we're back in it, and it's wonderful to be back there. We'll be back doing all of these things. It's going to be a celebration for 5th grade, and we're going to Conway. We've got 5th grade celebrations, a celebration for 4th grade. Summer's coming. There's so many things to celebrate, and that's what this night's really be about. It's a celebration of the journey that we've gone through the whole year in band and all of our learning. So let's see what's going to happen. You've already got a little bit of taste of what's going on. Our first number is 4th and 5th grade band combined. It's Let's Go Band that we closed the 5th grade concert with in the winter. And now we've got everybody moved into it. One of the first things we did, we got all the percussion together with it. So we're going to take a stab at it together. This is Let's Go Band, our 4th and 5th grade bands.
Thank you.
use some other percussion things that we have in the back. And this is a song we've been working on from our book. And it's got a nice key on it, everything is fine. And we should be good to go, okay? Just give me 1 second and we will be good. Notes and added to those in the fourth grade book at that point. We went for sharp, and then we added baby sharp, which they all know. We just learned the right notes and got it all together with that one. So you're going to hear sharp, our little version of sharp from Jaws, and then we're going to transition into a little baby sharp. Percussion is going to be battery, it's going to be taking this through all the way, but we can have that going on together. You'll hear bells and woodwinds first, their little baby sharp. The trumpets will go second, little pesto last, and then we'll play one big baby shark together, and everything will work out with that. Okay? So it's a shark and a baby shark.
Go somewhere with your notes. good section. Stand up. Stand up.
Moving along through, I see next is the trumpet section. We prepared a little duet of Canton Races. The first row is in front. We call that trumpet one because they're in the first row. They're going to play the A line and B line, correct? They go A then B. Row two goes B then A. So we should have some melody harmony both times and it flips through. Right, so here we go. This is Canton Races. Thank you.
second.
And we're all going to echo with them and go through it as a round. So this is our little version of Frère Jacques.
Two.
a nice round of applause. Fifth Grade Band's been playing for a little bit of time, so I'm just going to have them play a couple little things before we get started with Union March. So pretend there's a curtain that just closed and everything will be good. Okay?
I'll be right with you.
All right, I think we're ready. We've got the percussion in the right places and everything else. This is the Fifth Grade Band. We're going to be playing a little bit of march literature. This is very important for bands to know marches. There's lots of reasons why. But this is really our heritage. So we always try to make sure that we learn a march along the way between their fourth and fifth grade careers. And this is the one that we picked out this year. This is the Union March.
Thank you.
piece that's on the program that was playing at our PMEA Honors Band event that we had back in March. And Emma was our representative there. And Emma went over to Hampton and played that with a bunch of other people. And really, I picked something off of that program. We tried to schedule a lot of different things that happened off of that program too, because usually there's no one in the fifth grade band that can't go and play at that event. It's just unfortunate that they have to select just a few. And this year it was just Emma. So that was one that was on that concert. And we played it on our own with that really well, in March. And actually, I've been holding on to this since March, so you need to come up and get this. This is Emma's certificate from the Pennsylvania Music Educators Association from Hampton High School for her participation and representation of Peebles Elementary at that event. So come on up, let me get this.
Okay. Do you have set price? Are you good? Charlie, you got it.
piece we're going to do, kind of creature feature. And besides kind of making these little kind of creaturey, kind of creepy, crawly kind of sounds that are going to be going on staccato all the way through the ensemble, there's some different sounds that are happening. Mia, can you play the fire slap sound? Can you play the fire slap for everyone so they can hear it once? Give me a nice big one. Can you, with the mallet, you can get it. With the mallet, whoop. Okay, just do one so you can hear. Ah, yeah, the fire slap. It's a cool instrument. Mia, stand up and hold it up so everybody can see that. They don't see a fire slap very often. Stand up. Perfect, perfect. A lot of people know it as the one thing that happens at the beginning of Ozzy Osbourne's Crazy Train. Unfortunately, that is not the best place to learn about the virus stuff. It's a great sound. Do it one more time, Eva. One more time. Go ahead. Hit one more time. Good. So you have to listen for that as we go through. The other one, the flexitone. One of my other favorites. Connor, go ahead. So there's lots of interesting things that are going to be going on here with two interesting effects all the way through this. We've got some bell work that's going to be going on, some good clippity cloppity things. Yes, go ahead. There we go. The tick-tock of the clock as it goes along here. So this has a lot of neat things that are going to be going on. I hope you enjoy Creature Feature.
Thank you.
We're on to the Dance of the Jabberwock, which is, it sounds like a Star Wars creature, but it's not. We already went through that. It's based on Poe. There's a lot of stories that go along with it, but for us, it's an opportunity to move from 4/4 time into cut time and to move things along. We have it repeated along the way in this. And I think it's one of our better pieces. It's a nice piece to play. It's a lot of fun for us to do. So we're going to let this thing rip and see how it goes. We need the part. Okay, we got that. There it is. All right. So we'll have some other percussion sounds going on in this one, too. Continue with the miter slap, a little bit of ratchet, turn the ratchet for us. There we go, the ratchet's there. That's why we get those nice little percussion pulls. Okay, this is Dance of the Jabberwock.
Excited and proud of the work that she's done with that, so give a big round of applause. So, I got everything together, got the rushes out.
everything is good right there. All right, so Mrs. Valdez, where did she go? Oh, she must have had something to work for, something else going on in the hallway. We'll add one of the crash symbols later on when we do the in-school concert. That'll be good. We'll give her the crash symbol part to see exactly what's going to be going on. But I want to thank her for all of her support here, as well as the staff, the entire staff, the custodians that helped me put everything together, the secretaries that answer phone calls, making sure that everything is all set. I couldn't do this by myself. They're invaluable to us in making sure that it runs. So I want to thank them. I want to thank you for all of your support in renting the instruments, having them and encouraging them to practice at home, keeping all that stuff together. There are summer assignments coming out for the fourth grade. Yes, you should be playing through the summer. Hopefully you will, and be ready for fifth grade so we can move on to some other material. Fifth grade, I'll be wrapping up things with you guys and letting you know what you need to do to be prepared to move on to middle school. So that'll all be good stuff. I also want to make sure that I don't forget to thank Mrs. Parrish. Mrs. Parrish is a longtime friend of mine. She's been in the back helping out the percussion section. Came in this evening. If you give her a nice round of applause, she please. Especially the percussion section. Lots of things going on right there. She just happens to be sitting with Mia, but really, she actually helped out a lot of other things that I thought through tonight, so thank you very much for being here this evening. Okay? Now, I told you back in the December concert that, you know, I knew that the date was going to be May the 4th, so, you know, here we are, May the 4th be with you. We got to close with Star Wars. It's just the way things are going to go. So we're going to start this off with some low brass and percussion. We're using brushes back in the back with our snares and everything else. We've added a little bit of beat to begin. And then you'll hear the fourth grade is going to join us at the beginning and the end of this. In the middle section, the Anderson will lead our way through the little middle section. And we'll want everybody else to join. We'll get everybody going. Just put our head in there. And it'll be a nice finish to our evening. So thank you again for coming. And here we go. This is our version of Star Wars, main theme.
Lots of bells. Okay. Got it? All right, let's rock and see how we do here. them just for 1 second, and then you can do what you need to do, get home, get dinner, get homework, go to Brewster's, whatever you plan to do this evening. Thanks again for all your